Hello everyone, how's it going there? Sheffield Ram here, bringing you back a brand new video here on the channel. And today, guys, match day vlog is Derby County versus Charlton Athletic at Pride Park Stadium. And before I start this video, guys, as always, you should know by now how to do this. If you enjoy the video, make sure to hit the like, subscribe button, and click the little bell icon in the bottom right hand corner of your screen next to the subscribe button to be notified every single time I upload. It's as simple as that. If you're watching on YouTube, you like to follow me on Facebook, my name is Niall Biggs, active vlogger and gamer, and vice versa, if you're watching on Facebook, you like to follow me on YouTube, my name is Niall Biggs, the Sheffield Ram. So, on with today's video, guys. So, today, we play Charlton Athletic at Pride Park Stadium, and Charlton sit two places above Derby. It's a match that could probably defy where we finish in the season. As you all know, Derby County have been playing pretty terrible the past 5-6 games, and we've been struggling to pick up points, so it's a game that we really need to win. It's a game that we really need to pick up points in, otherwise we're going to be in a relegation scrap, you know, coming into 2020, and, you know, it's massive, massive contrast compared to where we were last season, you know. It's quite sad to see where the club's at the moment, you know. It's not what fans expect, it's not what pundits expect, it's not what really anyone expects Derby to be, you know. We're a side that's been challenging for promotion the past, what, 5 years, 5-6 years? And to, like, you know, come into this match, you know, basically 6 points above the relegation zone, it's quite a scary sort of thought, you know what I mean? Like, we should be like at least in the top half of the table. Like, even if it was what, like 12th or something like that, I wouldn't mind so much. But, you know, the fact that, you know, we're probably going to be in a relegation battle this season, that's sort of the scary part, you know what I mean? And, you know, imagine if we actually went down this season, you know, imagine if we went down after, you know, 5-6 years of pushing for promotion, and, you know, the one season where, you know, we've lost players, valuable players, you know, players that make a whole difference to the squad. Just imagine if that could be our downfall, and, you know, we'll be playing League One football next season. You know, it's going to affect us massively, this game is. So, yeah, that's why I'm praying for 3 points today. So Charlton, obviously, as you know, beat us in the league back in, I think it was September that we played them. They beat us back in September, and it was a 3-0 loss for us. In a game which pretty much was one-sided, you know what I mean? Like, the past, what, I think, like, the majority of our games this season, our away games have ended in 3-0. You know, there was the game against Brentford, Forest, Fulham, Charlton, Reading, you know, that's five games this season that we've lost 3-0 away. And literally only, literally only on Boxing Day is like when we actually scored an away goal for the first time in, like, I think it was 7 away matches or something like that. 7 or 8 away matches, I'm not too sure. But still, it's not good enough, you know, for a team that, you know, I say we want to be challenging for promotion, but obviously we're not doing that this season. But a team that should be challenging for promotion, you know, seven games without an away goal is pretty, it's shocking, you know. But yeah, anyway, hopefully we'll be picking up points this evening, and hopefully, you know, we can try and save ourselves a little bit going into the new year. Obviously, Wayne Rooney is coming in January, and possibly some more signings. Some players we've been linked with is Ferdi Kadioglu from Fenerbahce. Jack Clark's another one as well, whose loan spell with Leeds is coming to an early end. So they're two players that I know of that are going to possibly be coming in. We've also been looking at some centre-backs too, but I'm not too sure if they'll be coming in or not. But we definitely need a centre-back, because otherwise we're just going to be falling down the table. Because, let's be quite honest, Forsyth in that centre-back position really isn't good enough. He's not a born centre-back. He is a left-back at, like, at second best. Originally, Forsyth, in fact, was a left midfielder. It was only Clough that put him at left-back. So, you know, if we're going to play Forsyth, I think we should play him in the position that, you know, we actually bought him in for, which is left mid, and put Lowe in that that left-back position. And as soon as Clark or Bielik comes back, then put them in that centre back position. Otherwise, it's just gonna, you know, it's gonna be a massive, it's gonna be a massive defensive error if otherwise. But yeah, so today's match, I've got to sort of give a prediction. So considering how we've been playing, and considering our away, our home performance against Millwall, that sort of comes into it as well. And against Sheffield Wednesday, you know, a game which we got a lucky penalty in. My head's telling me a loss. My heart's telling me a win. I'm gonna have to go with my head. I'm gonna have to go with my head, I'm afraid, people. I'm gonna say a 2-0 Derby loss. I just think Charlton's got too much good players, and I just think the form that we're in at the moment, the position that we're in, I just think they'll get the better of us. Yes, we're a good side at home, but considering how we've been playing, you know, against the likes of Sheffield Wednesday, the likes against Millwall, you know what I mean, the teams that tore us apart, and we're really not looking a good team at the moment. So I'm gonna have to predict us for a loss today, and I don't usually do that. I normally like to think positive, but judging on the performances, I couldn't just see Charlton winning 2-0. Anyway, guys, I will see you guys at Pride Park Stadium in a few hours. So, until then, peace.
To Waghorn, played it through, he just hit the keeper, but a brilliant start. So we're only 30 seconds in. Looking really good so far, but I'm not going to jinx it. How about that, guys? It's 1-0 to Derby. I don't know who scored it, I don't know if it's the same goal, but it's 1-0, we've got the ball in the back of the net anyway. It's not come up as a goal announcement yet, but that normally means that it's an own goal. But still 1-0. That's a good start. That's brilliant. It's what we need. Bad challenge there. Okay, so apparently it was Jason Knight who scored, apparently. And yeah, we've just put it, as you see, we just put a tackle in there. Oh, sent him off. And we're down to 10 men. And that, we're winning 1-0, but we're down to 10 men. I don't know who that was. I don't know if it was. Is that Bielik?
Bielik.
It's Bielik. Bielik has gone off. So we're down to 10 men. Bielik's been sent off. So that means Charlton have got a one-man advantage. We're still winning 1-0, however, bear in mind. But now, with that hole in midfield, that can be a big turning point. Still with 10 men. Still the better team. I don't want to jinx it, I really don't, but we are playing good at the moment. We're having more of the ball, we're really putting Charlton's possession out. We're playing really good at the moment. I don't want to jinx it though, so I'll keep an eye shut.
Fucking up, Toby! Fucking up, Toby! Fucking up, Toby! Fucking up, Toby!
So Charlton crossed it in, and basically it flew over the keeper out, and for some reason the referee's given a corner when it was, in fact, a goal kick because the keeper never touched it. Now if they score from this, it's going to be so harsh. Still it out. Put it back in. In. Go on.
Okay guys, so it's half time here at Pride Park. It's currently Derby County 1, Charlton Athletic 0. And from the performance, it's been a satisfactory performance. Like, we've been looking a bit shaky when they've been coming forward. We got the goal in 10 minutes, it was Jason Knight, our first headed goal of the season. And the keeper saved the initial shot, Knight followed up. And it was a really nice goal, to be fair. It's his first goal of the season. Well, his first goal for the club, should I say. It was a really well-worked goal, and you know, we deserve to be in front at the moment. I think it was really harsh from the referee's point of view to send off Krystian Bielik. I don't really think it was a red card. Yellow at most, yeah, but not really a red card material. But, you know, to say that we've got 10 men at the moment, we're playing really well, we're playing good football. You know, we're holding our own, but I don't really think we should be resting on our laurels at the moment. You know, Charlton have been coming forward. They've been creating chances, they've been crossing into the box, and that's what they're doing well. But that's what we weren't doing on Watchcall when we played them at their ground. We weren't putting the crosses in, we weren't having that possession. And it's good to see us playing like that. It's good to see us playing, passing football again. It's good to like see us playing long balls too, and that's what sets up for the goal. So it's been a really good effort from the Rams so far. But like I said, I really don't think we should be resting our laurels at this point in the game. We need to push forward, get that second goal, and then possibly after we get that second goal, I think we can then afford to sit back and defend. Just leave, you know, one midfielder and one up front, and then just like see out the game. Because that's how we need to win the game. We need to win the game by parking the bus, just like snuffing out their efforts. And I think we can do that. You know, we're more than capable of winning this game. It will be hard with 10 men, but you know, hopefully we're going to see this game out. I'm praying to see this game out, because so far from what I've seen, we deserve the 3 points. But you know, it's always a tale of two halves, so half time. So we will see in the second half.
We hate Nottingham, say we hate Nottingham.
Go on.
Ooh. and we will fight forevermore because of boxing men. Oh, hell yeah, the Derby's safe before it's run away. He beat her like an egg, and when he came to Derby, he broke his fucking leg. Oh, Colin Moore's the wanker.
What? Oh, Ambo! Is it? He wants it? No one. Unlucky.
Robbie Savage! You're just a shit Robbie Savage! Shit Robbie Savage! You're just a shit Robbie Savage! Shit Robbie Savage! You're just a shit Robbie Savage! Shit
Robbie Savage!
Waghorn, Derby's number 9.
We're playing so well, creating so many chances, getting forward, whipping balls into the box. Knight, Low, Holmes all look really, really good, and this is really good to see. It's positive signs like this.
What's it like to see a crowd? What's it like to see a crowd?
Go on, Dwayne. This is it. Oh my god.
Yeah! Yeah! Night! Jason, motherfucking night!
If you don't fucking bounce, if you don't fucking bounce, you're in! If you don't fucking bounce, if you don't fucking bounce, you're in! If you don't fucking bounce, if you don't fucking bounce, you're
it. Jason Knight, I absolutely love you, you beautiful little man.
In the number, oh, in the ranks of my dreams.
Squeaky bum time, people, squeaky bum time. Charlton have just got a penalty now. I swear to God, we bottle this. We played so well up until now, we've given the penalty away. Lyle Taylor makes it 2-1.
Come on, Derby!
Still winning. But now it's squeaky bum time. Charlton will have their tails up. Way above the end of the shot. We need to stay on, we need to stay alert, we need to cut out. Keep going. Squeaky bum time, squeaky bum time. Time to the man. Avis dropped it. Out.
Get out of the knife, I know it's
on. Still got it.
Cross down.
Keep going. What a brilliant save from Ben Hamer. Hamer could have just won the game there for us. That was a brilliant save from Ben Hamer. Double save. Got it down. Bellows stretched his arm out. Got his hand to it. Follow up. He's fucking locked it with his body. It's just a big one.
brilliant double save.
Kevin Dobby! Come on, Dobby! Come on, Dobby! Come on, Dobby!
I've never been so nervous at the end of a game for a long time.
Come on,
we honestly, we deserve these 3 points so bad. We've been the best team from first minute to last. Play your whistle. Play your whistle, ref. Come on, ref. Play your whistle. Come on, ref, play your whistle!
Dobby!
We had 10 men! We only had 10 men!
10 men!
We only had 10 men! We only had 10 men!
Okay guys, so after a very, very topsy-turvy, after a very nervy end, should I say, it's finished Derby County 2, Charlton Athletic 1. And yeah, definitely guys, them last 10 minutes, well, about 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes, I tell you what, that's probably the most nervous I've been at a football game.
Hello!
You're boring bastard.
We only had 10 men!
10 men!
We only had 10 men! We only had 10 men! We only had 10 men!
10 men!
We had 10 men!
Anyway, so yeah, like I said, it's finished Derby County 2, Charlton Athletic 1. A very, very nervy end to the game. You know, Ben Hamer would probably, you know, a possibly season saving save right at the death. You know, I got to feel for Charlton a bit because they did try and push for that late equaliser. But you know what, I really honestly can't fault how we played today. You know, it was completely different to how we played against Wigan. Definitely different how we played against, Millwall and Reading. You know, we got good 3 points here against a team that, you know, dictates at their ground. You know, I'll happily take that 2-1 win. You know, that's bumped us up the table, and you know what? Every Rams fan here, that's given us a bit of a boost of confidence, especially after that performance, you know. So, yeah, that's basically the last game that we've played this year, you know. We finished the season, finished 2019 on a high with a really convincing win. And, you know, I think it was that belief that we had when we went down to 10 men. It's like, right, we've got 10 men now. We've got to sort of grind this out, and that's what we did. We played some really good football. You know, picked the right passes out majority of the time. You know, to be fair, they have got some very good defenders, but thing is, we just sort of grind it out. That's how you got to do it. Sometimes against teams, you got to grind it out, and that's what we did, and we did that really well. I'm not going to sit here and say Charlton were absolutely terrible, because they weren't. They did make some really good runs into our box. You know, they did threaten us at times, and that's not something to take lightly, you know. So I've got to give it to Charlton, you know, fair play. You know, you got a goal, you worked well for your penalty, so fair play. So if there's any Charlton fans watching, I'm lucky that you didn't get anything today, guys, but you know that this 3 points means a lot to us. You know, we need to survive, we need to like maintain our championship status this season. So sorry that it had to be at your expense, but you know, all the best for season for you guys, because you know, you did do really well against us at your place, so first play. You made a lot of noise to say you only brought like about 1,000. So, you know, I can't say a bad word about Charlton fans. So, that's basically it in terms of the match. So, that's the last match that we'll play until the big one, guys. The big man's coming. He's coming for the championship. So are we. I'll see you guys at Barnsley at home on the 2nd of January. So until then, guys, have a very happy new year, and I will see you then. Sheffield Rams signing out. Peace!